Hello, this is Solar Business TV from InterSolar Munich 2018. And we are at the first interview with Shawn Chu, the founder of Canadian Solar. Hello, Shawn, ni hao.
Hi, it's great to come to Munich and it's great to see you.
Okay, Shawn, so we didn't have opportunity to speak with Shanghai, but, you know, like we meet always, you know, every 2 weeks, every few weeks, every around the world. And here was very interesting, yes, because you launched new products, yes? And why did you choose Europe for the launch?
Well, we launch a new product every year. So sometimes we launch new product in Europe, sometimes in United States, sometimes in Asia, because we do have worldwide coverage. But Europe has a special place in my heart because 20 years ago, in 1998, I actually worked in Europe, in France, and that's where I learned my solar trick. Before I even started my company, Canadian Solar. So it's always an interesting place to launch our product.
And also it's interesting, yes, because Europe in the past was a big market, then Europe slowed down, but now I think that we see again that market is starting again, yes?
I think Europe is always an interesting market. And for Canadian Solar, high tide or low tide, oh, we always stay with our partners. In the past few years, we always maintain a strong team in Europe. We have always been working together with our European customers.
And Shawn, so we came here practically directly from China. And after snack, we had this news about cut of subsidies in China. So how do you think it will influence the Chinese industry?
I think China is going through what we have seen in Europe, that the government have provided subsidy to kickstart the industry. But at some point, the government feel like the industry already had a success, actually had a runaway success, and they get concerned about tax money. So then they said, well, we probably only have this budget, and the industry will have to live with the budget. We have seen this in many European countries. We have seen this in Spain, Italy, and Germany. Now we are seeing this in China. So it's not that much of a surprise to me. I think the whole industry will have to cope with it. And we are all adult, right? So we have to learn to live on our own. And fortunately, solar have grown so much, the technology have improved so much, and costs have reduced so much that we are almost at grid parity. Well, once we achieve grid parity, then we don't need subsidy to install solar.
So Shawn, just a few minutes ago we discussed about this solar lifestyle, yes? That we need to introduce solar lifestyle amongst politicians, business people and the society. And do you think that when we introduce this lifestyle, we don't need any subsidies? We just, you know, market will be growing by itself?
I think so. Lifestyle is very important. We want the whole society to understand the value of low carbon technology. And meanwhile, cost is also very important. We are bringing down the cost of solar so that live in a low carbon, green lifestyle doesn't cost you too much. If you have these two factors working together, we'll have a great future.
Okay, so the last question, Shawn, because now we will be going to Longi, to the founder of Longi. And you know, Longi is pushing for the mono technology. And we understood that you are still supporting poly, yes? Multi-crystalline technology. And I would like to ask you, why you choose, you know, still to support multi-crystalline technology?
Multi-crystalline silicon is silicon. Monocrystalline silicon is also silicon. For me, a PhD in physics, these two are pretty much the same technology with slight difference, slight variation. That's about it. I believe the multi-crystalline silicon technology will be able to provide a high efficiency, but also affordable solution to you. So if you want a powerful but also affordable solar panel, solar system on your rooftop, come to talk to me. If you want to have something expensive, if you want to have a super, superstar, you can always go to find a superstar, an expensive superstar.
Okay, so because last thing, because you remember we discussed about this forecast now that people, they say that mono will be growing. But you remember 2006 when there was silicon was so expensive and there was a lot of forecast that thin film will be like 50%, 60%, yes? And actually it didn't happen, yes?
That's correct. Thin film is also a competing technology. I believe all these technologies will have a space in the solar industry.
And we are at the end of the day working for the same industry and together we are stronger.
Yes, I think so.
Okay, thank you so much. That was Solar PV TV together with the founder and CEO of Canadian Solar, Shawn Chu, who is proposing to the market not to focus on one technology, but to find place for all technologies amongst the industry. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching.